Hello and welcome. My name's George and my channel's all about helping you get the most out of Logic Pro so that you can record and produce your best music in your home studio. Today, we're going to be diving into the new Chord Track feature found in Logic Pro 11 and showing you how you can incorporate it into your own music projects. So let's dive in. So for starters, to pull up the chord track, what you're going to want to do is to go up here under Global Tracks, where it says Show Hide Global Tracks, and click on that icon. And that'll bring this down. You can also press the letter G on your keyboard as a shortcut. And if you're not seeing the chord track right away, all you have to do is right-click, and under Chord, just click on that. And here you'll see our chord appears. Down here, we can map out the chord progression of our song. And this can help us in a few different ways. One, it makes it easy for us to follow along to the progression of our song. So for example, if I'm playing on my MIDI keyboard and playing along to the track, I can just glance up to the chord track and see which chord I need to play. It's also going to come into play if you decide to use any of the session players in Logic Pro 11, as these session players will follow the chords that are in this chord track. And lastly, from the chords in your chord track, you can also drag those down into your range window and convert those into MIDI, and then apply those to different instruments and edit the MIDI yourself. So let's take a look at all those different options. So as you see, I have a song that I've already been working on here, and I'm going to add the chords from this song into my chord track. So you'll see, for starters, the signature is set to D. So this is the overall key signature of my song. If you did want to change that, you just need to double click here and you can set that to whatever you'd like. So in this case, I'm going to leave it at D major. And then on my chord right here, by default, the first one is D, just because that's just mimicking the signature. But if I drag this over here and I press the plus button, this is where I can input my chord. And I can do this a few different ways. So I can do it using the mouse. So for example, I can select my different root notes. In this case, I'm going to stick with D. And then I can select the chord quality. So major, minor, sus2, sus4. 5, which would be like a power chord with no third, augmented, and diminished. And then I have a whole bunch of extensions that I can add as well. I can also change the bass note if I wanted a different bass note. So for example, on a D major chord, if I wanted the note in my left hand, in my piano, for example, to be an F sharp, well, I could set that to F sharp, or an A. So that would create my chord in different inversions, but you can select any bass note you want. So for example, a C, which is not a note found in the D major triad. I'm going to go ahead and stick with D or none. Now, if I want to move on to the next chord, the easiest thing to do is just to hit tab on your typing keyboard, and that's going to move over to the next bar. And then another way that I can input a note is simply just type in the next chord, which in this case is going to be F. So I'm just going to type in F, and from there I can just hit tab again, and you'll see that inputted F, and now I'm on the next bar for the next chord. Now another way you can input a new chord is using your MIDI keyboard. So if I click here, now I can actually play in the chord with my MIDI keyboard. So I'm going to do that now. And I played in an A minor, and that's what showed up on my chord track. And once again, I'll hit tab. And for the last one, I'm just going to type in a G and hit enter. So that's my 4-bar chord progression. I'm just going to click out of here. Now you'll see here it's set for 8 bars, but I only actually have the four chord progression. So I'm going to do is just go up to the edge here. And when you see those little brackets, then I can just click and drag. And that will shorten that. And now if I want to copy this, I can simply hold down Option, click and drag, and that'll copy my progression. Now let's say I wanted to edit any one of these chords. I could simply select there and let's say double click on the G, and that'll select just the G, and I can double click once more. And now I can change that again if I needed to. And similarly, if you wanted to change the timing, you would click on your progression, double click on the note, and you'll see that isolates the one chord. And now I can click and drag and change where the timing of that occurs. Now there's also some preset chord progressions you can look at. So if you select your chord progression and then right click, you can go here, chord progression, 251, 1564, 4165, and 6415. So if I select one of those, you'll see how those chords change. And these all relate back to our original key signature here. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that. And I'm just going to copy this for the duration of our song. Now, if your song did transpose at some point, so for example, in this breakdown section, if I wanted a key change, I could simply add a new key signature. And let's say I wanted this to go up to F, hit OK, and you can see how those chords all transposed based on here. So we went from D to F, and all of these chords followed that. Now again, I'm just going to undo that. So now that we have these chords, what can we do with it? So as I mentioned before, it can make it just easy to follow along. So if I wanted to play in a piano part, I know exactly what chords I need to play, but you can also use these chords and apply them to different software instruments. So for example, if I take this soft piano track, I'm just going to duplicate that by going up here and clicking on duplicate track. And I'll just mute that soft piano I have for now and solo this one. And if I just select and grab those chords down here, now you see I have this MIDI region with those chords in it, and it sounds like this. And I can double click on here, which will bring up the piano roll. And then if I want to edit any of these notes, let's say put this up an octave, I can do that and edit the notes any way that I want. I can shorten them, rearrange them however I'd like. Now, the other thing we can do is take advantage of the session players in Logic Pro. So for that, I'm just going to hide the piano roll. Right here, I'm going to right click. And instead of a MIDI region, I'm going to create a session player region. And right now, that created a drummer region. And that's just going to sound like this. So not exactly what we want for a piano part. So I'm going to, once again, double click in here. And we're going to want to change it from a drummer to a keyboard player. So here it says acoustic drummer, click on that. And before we change the type, I'm going to make sure that this change patch is turned off. And that's going to make sure that it doesn't change the piano sound that I have to something else. So I'm going to go to keyboard player and let's choose freely. So now that's going to keep the previous instrument I had loaded in, which was the soft piano from Spitfire Labs, which is free, I might mention. And now that sounds like this. Cool, right? So now let's see how that sounds like with our whole track. Now, a couple other things we can do to make this gel even better is to get this keyboard player to follow one of the tracks that are already in here. So, for example, if we go to the rhythm here, click on that, and right now it's following the chords, which is what we want. So it's following the chord track we have here, but we can also set it to follow another track. So, for example, we can get it to follow our bass track that I played in. And so if I solo both the piano and the bass, you'll be able to hear a little bit how that's matched. Now, if we wanted to have complete control over this track, then what we can do is convert this to a MIDI region. And then now I can delete any of these notes, move any of the notes around, and I have complete control over what's being played. Now, I'm just going to undo this and go back to the session player for a second. Now, right now, the session player is following our chord track, but we can also tell it to follow our own independent chords if, for whatever reason, we don't want it to follow exactly the chord track. And for that, we'll select our region, we'll go up here to the inspector, and where it says pitch source, we're going to go region chords. And you'll see here that right now it just says D. So if I solo that, now it's just staying on that D chord. Now down here, this is where we can edit the chords again. So if I right click, can go create chord, and let's say we want this to be an A minor, and then I'll hit tab again, G, F, and let's just finish that, repeat that again maybe. So now we've just changed up the order of the chords a little bit, and that sounds like this. So maybe you want to audition some different chords without changing everything in the chord track. That's one way you can do that. And let's say I wanted to replace these chords. So let's go ahead and delete that. With these ones, all I have to do is click and drag that region to the top here. And you'll see that that replaced this chord track with the new chords that I created down here. So I hope that helps give you some ideas on how you can incorporate the chord track in your own projects. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave those in the comments below. And if you want to improve your workflow in Logic Pro, don't forget to download my free Ultimate Logic Pro Starter Pack. This includes my Logic Pro Hotkey Cheat Sheet, my audio recording guide, my mixing guide, my gear guide, as well as my Logic Pro session templates. Thanks so much for the likes and subscribes. I hope you've enjoyed the video, and we'll see you in the next one.